Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Some time ago I published a short about a community plugin called Recipe View, and the guy called Pilo Adami, and please forgive me if I mispronounce your name, posted a comment by saying that it might be interesting to see how to use Obsidian in some day-to-day life system. So in today's video I will show you how you can transform a recipe note in an interactive recipe card that will help you to follow each step you need to cook delicious dishes. And lastly, we will build a beautiful database in a cards gallery view by using the minimal theme. But before we start, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you'll never miss any of my future content. And now, without further ado, let's get started. Let's start by installing the minimal theme and the community plugins data view and recipe view that we need to keep track of our recipes and build our personal recipe book. So for the theme, go to Settings, Appearance, Manage, click on Minimal, the most downloaded one, and then on Install and Use. Now, for DataView, go to Community Plugins, Browse, and search for DataView. Install and Enable. And then search for Recipe View, Install and Enable. If you click on Options, here you can configure some settings. The first one is about the side column sections. Basically, here you can decide which sections of the notes you want to be pulled into the side column, based on their headings. The default are Ingredients and Nutrition, but you can add any section you want. And lastly, if you usually use only one H1 heading at the beginning of your note, and you use it as recipe title that matches the file name, enable this option here. Okay, now let's take a look at the template I've prepared for our recipe notes. I added some properties and I already set the tag as recipe. Here I have the H1 heading that will be our recipe name, the ingredients and nutrition sections that, if you remember, will be pulled into the side column, the preparation section where I will list every step I need to follow, and lastly, a generic notes section. Now, it's important to use a bullet point list for ingredients, so as we will see, they will be converted into a checkable ingredients list. And regarding the preparation steps, any numbered list or sequences of paragraphs in the main column will let you click on a step to highlight it. Okay, let's try to create our first recipe. Let's start from a classic one. Create a new note. Let's call it spaghetti with tomato sauce. And then we insert the template. I use the file name as H1 heading, and I start to fill the property fields. So difficulty, very easy, prep time 10 minutes, cook time 1 hour and 10 minutes, and I can add the external link to the recipe here. Now, right after the H1 heading, I can insert an image as thumbnail for our recipe. I just prepared one here. And I copy-paste the name inside the cover property field that will be used later in our database. Now I write the ingredients. Let's add some nutritional information here. Now the steps. I've already prepared them, so I will just copy-paste them here. And the same thing for some notes and tips. Now, if I click on the recipe view button, I will have my beautiful recipe card. I can check the ingredients. I can highlight every step. And I can also scale the ingredients. Now, I already created some recipe notes here, and I want to see them in a database that will become my recipe book. Let's create a new note and call it recipe book. To create a cards gallery view, the first thing to do is to add some CSS classes to the note. I will leave the link to the minimal theme documentation in the description down below if you want to learn more about this. Anyway, for this example, I add cards to set the data view table that we are going to create to card layout. Cards cover, so the images will be automatically resized to fill the space. And table max, so the cards block fills the pane width. Now we need to create a data view table. If you are not familiar with data view, I already published a video about that and I will leave the link in the description down below. Let's write our query. And here you have your personal recipe book. As you can see, Obsidian with its community plugins has a solution for almost any use case. And now it can also help you in your kitchen. Remember, you can follow me on X and Mastodon, and you can also subscribe to my website for further content about productivity, PKM, and note-taking. I will leave all the links in the description down below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends who might need a solution to manage their recipes. Also, share your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, good cooking and stay productive.